She lived her life to the fullest and didn't let anybody put stop her. She when she did her art, she did it from her heart. Died without a penny to her name because she gave to everybody. It was just part of her. It was just part of who she was. My name is Jessie Archuleta. I am, can't tell you what number granddaughter I am of Epi Archuleta, but I am one of her granddaughters. Living with Grandma was amazing. She took care of all us grandkids, and there are a lot of us. And she made sure we all had something to eat. She grew her own garden. She took care of us. She put us all to work too, but she had a great work ethics. My grandma had a great work ethics. If she could teach you to weave, she had you on the loom just like everybody else. She started to weave since she was a little girl. Her father was a weaver, and then my great grandma was a weaver, and they had all their kids weaving. That was what they did for a living, and that's what they taught their family, and that's what they did. My grandma could weave anything. You could put a picture in front of her and she would weave it. Anything from dollhouse size weavings, that she would make little rugs for dollhouses, for people to put in dollhouses, and she would take them to the schools so she could sell them to the kids so that they could put them in their rooms or in their dollhouses, or she would make little wallets so they could carry in their pockets. Went from that size to covering your whole living room floor size. And if she could find material, or if I needed a dress for something, or any of my cousins needed a dress for something, she would just get on the sewing machine and hook them up with whatever kind of pattern they wanted. Even when we'd weave together, she'd say, "Oh, mijita, when there's a mistake in the rug, that keeps the bad spirits out." She just taught me things like that, you know?
Hello, my name is Chris Medina. I'm Epi Archuleta's second oldest grandson. So I moved here in 89 because my grandmother had a dream to open up a wool mill. She wanted to use this wool mill to create jobs for the people in the valley, starting with the farmers, buying sheep from all the farmers here, and create a product that she used in her rugs, so she knew exactly what she wanted. Along with my cousins, we actually built her own factory in her land in Capoline. Her wool mill is called the San Luis Valley Wool Mill. She had a consultant come from Oregon and taught me how to operate it. We all worked together as a family, so we're able to get everything going. It took us 3 years to get it going. She dyed her own wool through different herbs that were grown in the valley and in northern New Mexico. And it was really hard work. We'd get up at 5:30 in the morning to wash the wool, me and my cousins and my grandma. And my grandma came up with her own washing system. Then we put on these racks that she came up, and it would dry for a long time. My grandma had that wool recarded. It was coarse wool, was made out of that machine, so she changed the teeth for it can be fine wool. We put it in a hopper and it would come out in these rolls at the end, and then we put it in a spinning frame. And we got it fine-tuned, so finely tuned that my grandma was able to operate it. So once we got done with the bobbins, we had this skein winder and we can put just 10 at a time. And my grandma loved making the skeins. Once we got it going, my grandma had a job that she loved to do besides washing the wool. We had to get away from washing the wool. She worked so hard from sun up 5:30 in the morning till pretty much the 10 o'clock news.
She loved everything and everybody, and she kept her legacy alive. Yeah, she did it. She did it from the heart, and that's what made her great. My grandma was one of the most famous artists in Colorado. She's world renowned. I mean, she went to all the little festivals, and if they asked her to go to bigger festivals, she went to bigger festivals. She was just very persistent and just made her legacy known. Okay, this is a copy of my grandma's book, and it's a story of Juan de la Burro. It's one of her tall tales. It's very intriguing. So if you ever want a copy, Epi Archuleta's book of Juan de la Burro. Her E is on the right-hand side corner of every weaving she's done. It's her signature, and you know that's an Epi Archuleta original. After she was published in National Geographic, she started to become very world-renowned, and people started noticing her work and coming and visiting her and looking at her work and appreciating her art. And she just loved her. She just loved what she did. She could make anything. And she would tell you. She said, if I can't weave it, nobody can. The San Luis Valley Regional Hospital, Grandma has work in there. She has work in the Denver Airport. She has work in the Smithsonian Institute. She also has work in probably every art museum in Colorado.
My grandmother never stopped believing in helping people and using her weaving as a tool. She developed the EPR Chuleta School of Weaving, and she had quite a bit of students in there. She taught a lot of people here in the valley. Almost everybody who weaves in this valley learned from my grandmother.
Yeah, Epi Archuleta, she just would donate to any museum. She would love to make sure her art was known and seen and appreciated by other people. Just like she appreciated them, she appreciated sharing with them as well.
It was a very good experience until my grandfather passed away. And my grandmother pretty much closed the doors and she moved back to New Mexico. And that's where she carried on with the rest of her life.
Her legacy is phenomenal. It's just epic. Just, you know, Grandma was just, she was just a kind, beautiful woman. She really was. She had a heart of gold.
This video was created by the Sangre de Cristo National Heritage Area as part of their work in sharing the stories of our community. Thanks for watching.